strong policy work, Nana Godfredsen. Nana is the founder and director of Garden Juristen, the Danish street lawyers that provide outreach, legal aid, and harm reduction services for people who use drugs and advocating harm reduction and drug policy reform. Nana is the recipient of the 2011 Justice Gerald Ledain Award for achievement in the field of law, the 2008 Anchor of the Year, and the Junior Chamber International Outstanding Young Person of the Year Award in 2007. Nana?
Reduction services in your countries, or if you are new to this community, you do that, you start doing that as soon as you get back. We have to step up, we have to speak truth to power. We're in the middle of a huge emergency crisis. All over the world, people who use drugs are violated, harmed, suffering, and dying. And it's preventable, and we know what to do. Let's get it done. As street lawyers, we serve criminalized and de facto criminalized people. Criminalized not for evil, harmful stuff they do to others, but for what they are. It's a completely illegitimate form of criminalization, and it is inevitably leading to, or at least involving, a wide range of rights violations. Even in a so-called welfare state as the Danish. And I do, of course, know and I acknowledge and that lots are worse in many other places. But still, I need to warn you, it's not just the Danish kind of version you should head for. We need to do more, and I'll try to tell you why. What we do is, as you mentioned, Ajay, outreach, harm reduction days, legal aid services. We also deliver coffee and hot chocolate and cigarettes. They are extremely popular. And Christmas gifts and injecting equipment and crack pipes, you name it. So, but we are out there as lawyers on the streets. And this year it's been 20 years. I'm getting old, but it's amazing to see how others get inspired from it and adapt it locally to your own versions. Thank you so much for that. Indonesia, the Philippines, and elsewhere where I have colleagues today. Back then, a little more than 20 years ago, I was still a law student, and this started on the back of the police who had led on an extremely repressive law enforcement strategy, especially in Copenhagen. They called it a stress strategy, and they explained it with a mix of war on drugs and public order rhetoric. They just wanted to clean the area, and that's what they tried to do. This is a copy of a police map or police tool. This is the area right behind the central station in Copenhagen, and maybe you can see the circles. These were no-go zones. My apartment is in the local zone number 9. I was not harassed. It was used again, no-go zones users were banned from the area, they were stressed, they were fined, they were punished, they were arrested, and as a result, the death rate among people who use drugs in Denmark just increased dramatically during the 1990s. And there was